adding Kaltura videos into your Blackboard course. I'll begin by showing you how to access your top-level media repository, the place in Blackboard where you can always find and edit all of the videos you have created, or simply uploaded, using Kaltura. This area is called My Media in Blackboard. So when you're on the My Institution tab, you click the Kaltura My Media subtab, and then click the My Media link. This My Media area is also where you can add captions to your videos, use the video editor, or add a quiz to your video. Just click the title of the video, and then use the various options under the Actions button in order to select what you want to do next. Now let's look at options for adding your Kaltura videos into your Blackboard course. I'll click on My Institution, and then My Institution, and I see my course list. Now, let's say that you had already recorded a video or had used Kaltura's personal capture tool to record a video and upload it into Kaltura My Media. Now you want to add that video into a particular course and into a specific unit folder in your Blackboard course. So I'm going to open my course. Now, just navigate to the location where you want to add the video. I'm going to add it into my Chapter 1 folder. Click the Build Content button and select Kaltura Media. From the My Media list, click the Select button next to the video you want to add to the course. Enter a title for the video, and then click Submit. Remember, the mashup will always be at the bottom of the list of objects in the folder, so you will always need to drag and drop it into the correct location in your folder sequence. Now, just clicking on the mashup link opens the player window. Another way to add a Kaltura mashup link into your course in any of the Blackboard tools that use the text editor is to use the Kaltura mashup drop-down option in the text editor. For example, you can add a Kaltura video into an announcement, a discussion post, or an assignment. Your students can do this too using the same approach. Let's say I wanted to add a short welcome video into my first announcement. I'll click the Announcements tool. Now I create or open an existing announcement, and then I place my cursor into the location in the announcement where I want the video to appear. I click the Mashups button and select Kaltura Media. Then again, I just click the Select button, and the mashup is inserted into the location in the text editor that I had selected. Now click Submit. Clicking the mashup thumbnail opens the Kaltura player. Another option called Media Gallery or Course Gallery enables you to provide a button on the course menu that enables you to make all or just some of your Kaltura videos available all in one place. To use this option, you first need to add a tool button on your menu. If you're not sure how to do this, just ask your local EdTech director for assistance. But here's a quick demo. Click the plus sign on the top of the menu and select Tool Link. Type the name Media Gallery. From the Type dropdown, select Media Gallery and click the Available to Users checkbox. Then click Submit. Note that the New Menu button appears at the bottom of your menu, so you must drag it to the correct location in your menu, normally right below the Course Content button. Click the Media Gallery button. To add new videos to the gallery, click Add Media. From the list of videos, click the little checkboxes to the left of each video that you want to appear in the gallery. When you're done, click the Publish button at the top right. The videos will all now appear in your course media gallery. If there are captions in your video, when students select the video, they can click the magnifying glass and search on specific words or phrases. Let's say I want to search on the word Canadian. I enter the term into the search box, and every reference in the video is listed. I can then click the time link to jump directly to that section of the video. If you have questions or want more details about how to use Kaltura in your Blackboard courses to deliver video, please contact your local EdTech director.